standing. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this groom and his bride in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate. Please be seated. Let us have a word of prayer. Almighty God, Heavenly Father, we pause momentarily to give you glory. Thank God for safe travel, family, and prayer. We ask you to honor today by the aid of the Holy Spirit to bless all that you do today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
The bond and union of marriage was ordained by God from the beginning of creation. Therefore, it should not be entered into inadvisably or lightly, but reverently and deliberately and voluntarily. For marriage is sacred and a joyous covenant. And into this sacred covenant of marriage, God has ordered the union of husband and wife in heart, mind, and body. It is God's will that a husband and wife should love each other throughout their lives and support each other with patience, understanding, wisdom, and honesty. A husband and a wife should give each other companionship, help, comfort, honor, love, and respect in times of prosperity and in times of adversity. Also, your children should be nurtured by your union, and they should enjoy the security of loving parents, family, and a loving home. And it is for these reasons, said our Lord, that a man shall leave his parents and be joined to his wife, so they no longer are two, but one. Can I get one amen right here? So therefore, if any one of you can show just cause why Shawn Crawford and Sabrina Curtis, who have now come to be joined in a holy union, may not lawfully be joined in marriage, let them speak now, or else hereafter forever hold their peace. What therefore God joins together, let no one separate. Now at this time, Shawn and Sabrina, I have a charge for both of you. Shawn and Sabrina, your marriage is intended to join you for life in a relationship so intimate and personal, it will offer you a steadfast love, a love that is true and mature. To attain such love, so that you may grow old together, you will have to commit yourselves to each other freely and gladly for the sake of continually finding in each other the resources which will nurture your marriage and deepen your love for one another as the years go by. Therefore, I call your attention to the seriousness of the decision you have made in choosing each other as the one with whom you will spend your life. Be very clear that your marriage is dependent upon your willingness to be faithful to each other, for unfaithfulness is a betrayal of your covenant. I need an amen right there.
Amen.
Now, before we even get married, I'm going to ask your consent to be married. And after I have spoken the declaration, I want you, Shawn, to say, I will. And after I read the declaration, you will say, answer by saying, I will. Shawn, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, share the responsibility and share the growth and the enrichment of your life together? And from this day forth, you shall be hers alone, forsaking all others, be faithful only unto her, so long as you both shall live. Please answer by saying, I will.
I will.
Sabrina, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and share the responsibility for the growth and the enrichment of your life together? And from this day forth, you shall be his alone, forsaking all others, be faithful only unto him, so long as you both shall live. Please answer by saying, I will.
Here come on, I will.
Who stands at this time with this woman to symbolize the traditions, the family from which she comes? And your dad stand? He's already standing. Amen. And do you give this woman to be married to this man? Please answer by saying, we do. We do. God bless you. May be seated. Mom, would you come and stand at this time? Dad. Who stands at this time with this man to symbolize the traditions, the family from which he comes? And do you give this man to be married to this woman? Please answer by saying, we do. God bless you. You made me sit down. God bless you. The scriptures read as follows in Proverbs 18:22. The man who finds a wife finds a good thing, for she is a blessing to him from God. In the New Testament, we read in 1 John 4, verses 7 through 12, Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And he who loves is born of God and knows God. But he who does not love does not know God, for God is love. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. And if we love one another, God abides in us, and his love is perfected in us. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to exchange the vows. Amen. And Shawn, I want you to begin with you. And repeat after me. I, Shawn.
I, Shawn.
Take thee, Sabrina.
Take thee, Sabrina.
Now let me move back so you can look at her and not me. Amen.
Okay.
Y'all gonna have to get a little bit closer now. It's warming up, y'all. It's getting a little. It's warming up now. Amen. Amen. All right. Let's start this over. I, Shawn.
I, Shawn.
Take thee, Sabrina.
Take thee, Sabrina.
To be my wedding wife.
To be my wedding wife.
To have.
To have.
And to hold.
To hold.
From this day forward. From
this day forward.
In joy.
In joy.
And in sorrow.
And in sorrow.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
In health.
To love.
To love.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
As long.
As long.
As we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
And according to God.
And according to God.
This is.
This is.
My solemn.
This is my solemn.
Vow.
Vow.
Amen.
Amen.
I, Sabrina.
I, Sabrina.
Take thee, Shawn.
Take thee, Shawn.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have,
to have,
and to hold,
and to hold,
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
in joy,
in joy,
and in sorrow,
and in sorrow,
for better,
for better,
for worse,
for worse,
for richer,
for richer,
for poorer,
for poorer,
in sickness,
in sickness,
and in health,
and in health,
to love,
to love,
and to cherish,
and to cherish,
as long,
as long,
as we both shall live. And according to God,
and according to God,
this is
my solemn vow.
Let's have an amen here. This time we're going to be blessed in song by the bride.
Here we are, all now together, it's you and I. God has made us fall in love, it's true. I've really found someone like you. Will it stay? The love you feel for me, will it say that you will be by my side to see me through? I found strength in you. Oh, but in my mind, we can conquer the world. In love, you and I. That in this life I found someone who may not be here forever to see me through, but I've got strength in you. I only pray that I will show you a bright today. Because you're all I am living for, you see. 'Cause I found you in me. Oh, but in my mind, we will stay here always in love. You and I, you and I, you and I.
Amen. I'm about ready to get signed up again. I'm gonna get married again after that one. Amen. You blessed us. You really, really blessed us. Didn't you? Let's give it a little bit more love.
Shawn and Sabrina have come to publicly proclaim their love in a new union of marriage. And when a husband and a wife are joined together by love and live together in peace and harmony, God is in their midst. And in the home where God's presence dwells, great moral virtues are expressed more by example than by precept. And the joy of living is found in shared task and responsibility. There is a mutual loving kindness, a mutual respect for one another, a mutual devotion, and the light of peace remain kindled in your soul. Shawn and Sabrina, you do not lose your individuality, but you remain united in so close a bond that you truly become one flesh. Amen. Beloved of God, just as a signature bears witness to a written covenant, the wedding rings are the traditional outer symbol of the vows of marriage accepted on the wedding day. Father God, do you have the wedding rings? Open them here. Father God, bless these rings and bless the giving of these wedding rings, because a wedding ring has no beginning and no end. The unbroken circle of a wedding ring sets forth the eternal nature of real love, for these blessed rings represent the love and the trust that Shawn and Sabrina have promised to each other on this day. Shawn, would you take the ring first and place it on the ring finger of your bride's hand and repeat after me? This ring, hold the Lord in. This ring is the sign.
Is the sign
of my promise before God.
Is my promise before God.
My relatives and friends. To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband. I give this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Amen.
Amen.
Please take the ring. Place it on the ring finger. And repeat after me. This ring is the sign.
Is the sign
of my promise before God.
Of my promise before God. My relatives and friends.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife. I give this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Let us bow our head. Can we pray the Lord's Prayer together? Our Father, which art in heaven. By the power vested in me by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, for as much as Deshaun and Sabrina had made this solemn covenant of marriage before God and all of us here, by the giving of wedding rings and this bride and groom's willingness to share their lives and faithfulness together to love one another. It's getting good now, get close. You might better stand up. I announce to you that they are now husband and wife. You may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Deshaun and Sabrina.